When we talk about pitchers and we're looking at pitchers to be prospective student athletes here at Ohio State, one thing that's really critical for us is their ability to throw a second pitch, and that second pitch in most cases is a curveball. So it's very important that our pitchers have the ability to spin a good breaking ball and get some depth on that breaking ball to keep the hitters off balance.
Coach, how much do you want your players thinking about aerodynamics when they throw a curveball?
That's a good question, and I think the answer to that question is I want them not to be thinking about them, but I want them to understand it.
So are you ever thinking about aerodynamics when you're throwing the pitch?
No, never. I'm just thinking about trying to get it across home plate and trying to make the batter swing and miss.
So when you run your hand across the baseball, you can feel the individual seams on it. The air that you're throwing the ball through is the exact same way. It feels those seams. So as you're putting a spin on the ball, those seams and the ball itself to an extent is dragging air along with it as it spins. And what that's doing is that's moving, it's slowing down the air on the top of the ball because it's moving into the wind, speeding up on the bottom, and it's creating a pressure difference.
From the Bernoulli equation, there's a relationship between pressure and speed. And so that Bernoulli equation tells us the lower speed air on the top is gonna have higher pressure, and the higher speed flow on the bottom is gonna have lower pressure. You got high pressure and low pressure that causes the ball to drop, which makes that curveball break. And another word for that is the Magnus Effect. A German engineer back in the 1800s first discovered this, where you've got a spinning ball or a spinning cylinder having that high pressure on top and the low pressure on the bottom. That's the basics of a curveball from an aerodynamic standpoint. Not that I could ever throw one. But
you hold the curveball like this with your middle finger on the lace and really put pressure on that. And you throw it just like a fastball, but at the last second you want to flip your wrist over and really get some flick so the ball's spinning forward and then dropping off at the last second, so it's just flicking your wrist.
So you actually create the spin, but then aerodynamics takes over and does the rest of the work.
Yeah, I guess so. I guess it does work like that. Never really thought about it.